So here we are on Thursday, the 14th of September, for evening prayer and seven steps to becoming a Christian. And we're at step five, believe it or not. So let's just take the steps very quickly. Is there a God? Is there more? Yes, no. So that's a decider to start with. If there is a God, what is he like? And we've said one of the biggest answers is that he is love. Then we looked at what am I like on day three, you know, the way I go wrong, the things that I do that, just try and control my world, but they don't work out. And then we said, well, what would God do about that yesterday? If he loves us and he knows we've gone wrong, what would he do? And the amazing reply is that he becomes one of us here. But then we have to say on day five, who is this man? And that's important because we often people know very little about Jesus. They know kind of the headlines, you know, he was born in a manger and he died on a cross. But in between, they're very vague about the kind of things he said and what he did. But and I can't go into all that now. You might want to look up a poem, a really old poem on the internet called One Solitary Life. And it takes you through the things that Jesus did and says how that life has affected the human race, really. And certainly all those around him, they did one of two things. They either were magnetized into his realm, that they kind of were so attracted to his simple teaching, well, simple at one level, very dramatic power and his love and many other things besides. And there are others who were quite repelled by it because he was challenging the powers of the day and even the powers within me, you know, that wants to be in charge, as we said earlier. And so it's really important, if we're going to do any journeying like this, is to know a little bit about Jesus. Did you know you can read Mark's Gospel, which has about 16 chapters, does have 16, in 45 minutes? So it's not much of your time to read a gospel, is it? Some are a bit longer, but that Mark's gospel, in about 45 to 50 minutes, you could read the whole thing and just get an overview of Jesus's life. Who is this man? Or as again, C.S. Lewis, I quoted before, says, what are we to make of Christ? Big question. Our song tonight is the only one of my seven that is, I suppose, a bit more Christian than others. But I chose it because it says a lot of what Jesus came to do in his life, not just in his death, which we'll look at tomorrow. And the song is by Rend Collective, and it's simply called Rescuer.
There is so much bad news in the world right now, but no matter what, we have good news, and that good news has a name, and that name is Jesus Christ.
There is good news for the captive, good news for the shame. There is good news for the world who walked away. There is good news for the doubter, the one religion failed. For the good Lord has come to seek and save. He's our rescuer.
Riches for the poor. He is friendship for the world. The world
come to the foot of Calvary. There is redemption for every affliction. Here at the foot of Calvary.
So we pray. Lord, a lot of things have been said about you in the world. Some of them were most unhelpful, and some of them are bitter, and some of them are difficult. We want to cut through those and hear what actually your life is about. Once, when you were with your friends, you said to them, well, who do people say I am? And they gave off this list of some say this, some say that. And then you looked at them directly and you said, yeah, but you, who do you say I am? And as we look at Jesus's life, his ministry, his healing, his deliverance, his teachings, his character, his way with people, his parables, help us to get that full picture of the real Jesus Christ. And help us to let that picture sink into our minds and hearts today as we journey on to know him more. And we say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow for day 6 and looking at a particular culminating part of Jesus's life.